Well, some people who contract COVID never regain their sense of taste and smell. Tonight, how doctors at Washington University are researching whether you can train your brain to learn how to smell again.
A serious safety and quality of life issue persists for some people who've had COVID. Between 40 and 80% of people who've had COVID lose their sense of taste and smell.
The good news is that for most of them, after 2 to 3 weeks, their sense of smell and taste comes back, but not for everybody. So we think that probably 5 to 7% of people, 2 months, 3 months after their COVID, they still have smell and taste problems.
Dr. Jay PICCIRILLO sees it a lot. People can no longer appreciate food or common odors you take for granted.
A mother describes to me her embarrassment when she couldn't smell her baby's diaper.
Other patients say the smell they do have is a constant bad odor, like smoke.
I had one patient who said, "I would rather not smell anything at all than to have this distortion of my smell."
Could this be permanent?
Well, so the pandemic's only a year, so we don't have long-term, but it absolutely could be a permanent problem, the sense of taste and smell disturbance that they're experiencing.
Dr. PICCIRILLO is now enrolling participants in a research study to see if you can retrain the brain to smell again. Bo Anderson, a baseball player at Washington University, is taking part.
So I started the study about a week ago.
He lost his taste and smell in November when he had COVID. He can taste some things now, but can't smell anything.
You can't necessarily smell whether or not your food's burning.
He and others choose 4 essential oils they smell twice a day, such as rose, lemon, cloves, or eucalyptus.
The rose one I can actually, get a pretty distinct odor from, which I was very surprised about.
About half of the participants are also getting visual training to see if looking at something will trigger smell. As a baseball player, Bo says smell is something he really misses.
Just smell of fresh air or smell the baseball field when I'm out there playing. And, it's obviously not a major thing that I can't smell at the moment, but it's just something that I'd like to get back, of course.
WashU is still taking people who want to enroll in this study. Dr. PICCIRILLO hopes to have the results in May. And you can find out more by going to our website, fox2now.com.